Hello friends, today we are going to understand one of the important topic of research methodology, that is sources of data collection in research. First of all, let us understand meaning of data collection. Data collection is defined as the procedure of collecting, measuring and analyzing accurate insights for research using standard validated techniques. A researcher can evaluate their hypothesis based on collected data. In this video, we are going to understand sources of primary data collection in research methodology in detail. Let us start with meaning of primary data. Primary data is the kind of data that is collected directly from the data source without going through any existing sources. Primary data is often reliable, authentic and objective in as much as it was collected with the purpose of addressing a particular research problem. Example, census. Data collected by the government to enumerate the population. Primary data can be collected through survey methods, observation methods and experiment methods. So now started with method number one, survey methods. The survey method of obtaining information is based on questioning of respondents. Respondents are asked variety of questions regarding their behavior, intentions, attitudes, awareness, motivation, and demographic and lifestyle characteristics. We are going to study four survey methods. 1. Personal interview. A personal interview is a form of direct communication in which an interviewer asks respondents questions in face-to-face situation. The method of collecting information through personal interview is usually structured or unstructured. Structured interview involves the use of a set of predetermined questions and of highly standardized technique of recording. Unstructured interviews are characterized by a flexibility of approach to questioning. Interviewers are allowed much freedom to ask supplementary questions or maybe even omit some questions. But analysis of unstructured interview is difficult and time-consuming. For example, asking questions to respondents at their home for survey based on home delivery. 2. Telephone interview. Telephone interview is considered cost-effective and dominant data collection method. Interviewer contacts the interviewee on telephone. That is, there is no face-to-face contact but only verbal contact. Example, two parties may decide to use voice calls through mobile or tablet to carry out the interview. 3. Mail. Mail interviews can be conducted via ordinary mail or email. In this method, questionnaires are mailed to potential respondents who in turn fill and return them at their convenience. For example, feedback form sent by garment shop to their customer in the form of mail. 4. Internet survey. Google form. In internet survey, a self-administered questionnaire posted in website. Many a times, respondents are recruited and are asked to visit a particular website and complete the survey. In other cases, people happen to be visiting the website where survey is posted. Respondents provide answers by clicking on icon or keying in the words. Example, any company or an organization uses an online survey method for its improvement in marketing or to check customer experience. Category 2 in primary data collection is observation method. Observation research is a qualitative research technique where researchers observe participants' ongoing behavior in a natural situation. Depending on the type of observation research and the goal of the study, the market researcher will have varying levels of participation in the study. We're going to study 5 types of observation methods. First, direct versus indirect. Direct observation occurs when the observer is physically present and personally monitors what takes place. The observer plays a passive role. That is, he does not attempt to control or manipulate a situation. Example, if anyone wants to find the information regarding trending brand of watches, then simply look at the online list of the brand's ranking instead of asking someone. Indirect observation occurs when the recording is done by mechanical, photographic, or electronic means. For example, special cameras mounted in malls, shops, etc. Second, disguised versus undisguised. Disguised observation is used to obtain insights into customer behavior without letting the customers know that they are being observed. This is particularly done when people may behave differently if they know they are being observed. For example, several researchers seek admission to 12 different mental hospitals to observe patient-staff interactions and patient diagnosing and releasing procedure. In non-disguised observation, people will know that they are being observed for the purpose of research. For example, respondents are informed well in advance that they are under CCTV surveillance and are being observed by researcher in mall. Third, structured versus unstructured. Structured observation is used when research problem has been formulated precisely and observers have been told specifically what is to be observed and how the measurements are to be recorded. Observer will be given instructions or questions of how to observe particular situation, which is called an observation checklist, which is similar to questionnaire. For example, a developmental psychologist is interested in helping behaviors in toddlers. They want to use structured observation, so a coding method is developed. Unstructured observation is free to observe whatever they think is relevant and important. That is, they will not have any particular set of questions with them according to which they'll observe. For example, examining the experiences of elderly people admitted to care. In this situation, the researcher will take numerous field notes and may use tape or video recording. Fourth, human versus mechanic. Human observation is similar to direct observation, where an observer is physically present to record the events. An observation form is often used to help keep the observations consistent and to ensure that all relevant information is recorded. For example, staff is observing queue at bill counter to study impulsive buying. In mechanical observation, mechanical devices record the phenomenon being observed. It has been developed to overcome particular deficiencies in human observer. This method is free from human bias. For example, counting number of cars at toll plaza through FASTag scanner. Fifth, participative versus non-participative. Participant observation refers to an observation situation in which an observer gains first-hand knowledge by being in or around the social setting that is being investigated. He acts both as observer and participant. Sometimes he is known as an observer to some or all of the participants. At other times, the true role is concealed. For example, studies where researchers lived for long periods of time among different ethnic, cultural, or religious communities. In non-participative observation, on the other hand, the observer has a passive role and does not come in direct contact with the respondents. He makes observation from a distant place and records what he observes. For example, when researchers sit in on meetings or workshops on site, but do not actively participate. Category 3 in primary data collection is experiment method. Experiments carried out for the purpose of collecting data to be analyzed and studied are carried out in the laboratory, in the field, or using computer numerical models. It also can be a combination of two or three of the said techniques. Example, you wonder whether a plant grows if you mist it with water. We are going to study two data collection experiment methods. One, field experiment. Experiments carried out in the field require careful planning and coordination. higher contingencies in terms of budget and time must be considered. Controlling and monitoring the changing parameters on site could also involve other parties and the law. Security of instrumentation must be taken seriously. Example, an astronaut looking at the night sky and recording the data regarding the movements or brightness of an object in outer space. Second, laboratory experiment. Laboratory experiments are a research method by which researchers create controllable environments to test hypotheses. Laboratories used for academic research are rooms or specifically designed spaces. Example, a scientist looking at a chemical reaction in an experiment. So these are the points covered in primary data collection in my video. I hope my video helps you in clarifying this topic properly. Thanks for watching my video.